Hey, Pascal here, and in this video I will tell you how to use flight modes on the Mavic Air or other DJI drones to get cinematic shots. I would say that the Mavic Air is a drone that a lot of people get as their first drone, so of course it's a lot of fun flying around and so on, but also a lot of people also want to get the best shots with it and want to make their videos for YouTube or even like their normal holiday videos better. And of course it's always about getting those cinematic shots, especially when it comes to drones. So let's talk about that and how you can use quick shots or other flight modes to get cinematic shots. But let's first talk about what makes a shot actually cinematic for both drones and cameras. And I would actually say that one of the most important things here is to get a fluid or like soft motion. So in most cases the camera just moves in one direction and it's not like changing directions accidentally or something. That looks pretty amateurish. What you want to have is like usually one direction, or if you change directions, then you want to have a smooth transition between those movements. Like when I would move my drone forward and then suddenly go left, looks amateurish. But when I do like a curve, a longer curve to go left, then it can actually look cinematic. So that's pretty important here. Of course, you don't want to have any jitters or something in your drone. It looks should look steady, but that's usually the case with drones, so I don't need to talk further about that. And yeah, the next thing is, I want to mention that before, one really good thing about all the quick shots and flight modes is that you can easily use it for storytelling, because you want to have every clip in your final video to have a purpose. You don't want to just put in some random clips, no. You want to tell a story, and you can, for example, do that if you start with a revealing shot that shows a big beach or something. Then the next shot could be like a medium or not close, but a medium or long shot where you are walking down the beach. Then maybe the next shot is where the camera comes a bit closer to you. Then maybe the next shot is a girl that's also a bit closer, that also walks around the beach, and then you met each other or something. So you tell a story, you show the beach, and you present the persons, and then you bring the persons together, always those shots. Of course, this doesn't necessarily relate to travel movies, this example, but even with travel movies, you usually want to have like a structure in your videos to tell the story. And quick shots modes are pretty good for that, when you want to present yourself in the shot and yeah, be basically like the main person that tells the story. So yeah, for that all those flight modes are perfect, so let's get into it. So from my experience, actually, it's my third drone. I had the Phantom 3 Standard before, I had the Mavic Pro before, and the Phantom 4 Pro, and then I got the Mavic Air. And I must actually say that the Mavic Air offers the most flight modes of all drones, so that's cool. But of course the flight modes are more designed for like people that just want to get a nice shot, but it's not really designed to make everything cinematic, right? So what I want to tell here is my best tips on how you can use those modes to get cinematic shots. So I must honestly say that most of the time I actually used modes like active track, like not the quick shot modes, because that gives me a lot more flexibility to control the drone, so it's pointing or following a person, and then I can still control the drone, like flying in a circle around of it or flying high, pointing the camera up and down and so on. So that helps a lot to get the shots that I want to have. But of course it's a bit harder when you want to film yourself and you have your controller in your hand, and that's where quick shots modes are actually a bit better, because you can actually just put the controller away and the quick shot mode will still happen without you doing anything, and that's pretty cool. But there's some downsides with the quick shot modes, and that is that you usually need to stay in one place. So I tried walking around a bit when doing a quick shot mode, and the drone was not really following me most of the time, so Yeah, it really doesn't work out that good if you want to move yourself. But if you want to stay in one place, let's say you're on the cliff or something and you want to reveal the cliff in front or behind of you, then of course quick shots are a good option for that. So let's go through the quick shots here. The first quick shot I want to discuss with you, and it's actually a pretty famous one, that is a drone-y. I mean, like this, like the name says, drone-y is a bit like selfie, so it's designed to make basically a selfie, but the nice and the actually cinematic part of it is that the drone flies backwards away from you. So I like that pretty much because it's like, of course, at first a revealing shot. So you can start with showing yourself to the camera or to the viewer. And then when the drone goes back, all the background behind you reveals. And that's awesome. It can be good for like an intro or something when you want to show where you are. But it can also be a good outro because like the camera is moving away from you. It's not just revealing, but it's also going out of the scene. So it can also be a good outro shot. Or just, let's say you change the scene. You like, let's say you've been in your apartment before and now you change to the beach and you want to show the beach after you show yourself or something. So it's actually a good storytelling tool. But with the drone, you also need to be a bit careful because if you want to get the complete movement, then it can actually be that you need to speed it up. And then let's say you're on the beach or something, then the waves become pretty fast. And that doesn't look very nice in the video later. It's actually better if the waves have a natural movement, also like cars driving by and so on. That doesn't look so cool. But what you can do is, for example, you can set your Mavic Air to 2.7K and then 60 FPS. Or if you film in 1080, you can also actually use 120 FPS, which is pretty cool. And then you can start with a slow-mo shot, like actually everything is a bit slowed down, cars driving slower, you move a bit slower and so on. Then the camera, you can speed it up like while flying back from you according to the music, so that you actually cut the point where the speed increases to the music and the out point, the point where it gets back to a normal or a slow-mo speed. Also to the music, and then you have a slow-mo up in the air again, so you can actually adjust this shot pretty good to the music, especially when you film a bit slower, because then you get a bit more footage to work with. So my tip here for the drone-y. And the next shot I want to talk about here is the circle, and the circle is actually a quite nice shot. I like it, and that's because it has this nice parallax effect. Like when you circle around one object, then the object in the middle doesn't move at all, or it only moves very slow depending on what kind of circle you fly, and then you get a parallax effect because the background moves pretty fast. And I like this effect, it looks pretty nice. But also the shot is nice from a storytelling perspective to also reveal the area but in another way, because like usually if I would do a drone-y, the camera flies back away from me and I reveal all the stuff that's going on behind me. But with a circle you can reveal everything that goes around you, so that's pretty nice. And it can also do something like a bit longer shot, and you move the drone, the camera a bit more slowly. Then you can make it like a shot where you're thinking, like you put in a voiceover where you're reading a text, and this text should reflect some thoughts that you have walking around, and the camera is flying around you because it's like circling around your thoughts, right? So that's actually also something that you can easily do, and that's a pretty nice effect though. And there are also some variations about the circle shot. This is the boomerang and the helix. I must actually say that I don't like the helix so much because it's not like moving so far away that it does so much, so much more than the circle itself. But the boomerang mode is pretty nice. I like it because it's also a circle but more like an egg form. So it's not just like flying a normal circle. It actually flies further away from you and comes back. And that's also cool to reveal a scenery. Like actually on the DJI announcing event from the Mavic Air, they put in some of the best shots that you can get using that quick shot. And this is where this, I don't know his name, one of the founders or marketing managers of DJI is standing there at the cliff, and the drone starting in front of him. You see him like standing there, and the drone is moving behind him and reveals like the ocean. Looks awesome. I love that. So I would say that this, especially the helix shot, is not something that you can use everywhere, but in some places it really gives the most impressive shot that you can get. So keep that in mind when you're on the right place, like for example standing on a big cliff. The next quick shot here is the rocket, and as you probably know, it's like the drone moves up and the camera points down to you. So that's interesting because you show yourself and the camera goes away from you, but you don't show much more of the area around you, right? Because like usually around you are just some trees or maybe the normal ground or a street or something. So it's not that interesting what you bring more in the shot. So if you not really want to reveal something, but you want yourself or the objects that you're filming go or become smaller, then this is a shot that you can use pretty good. So of course it's also good for an ending shot with that, where you don't want to reveal something more because it's the end, and yeah, just use it. It's good when the camera goes up then. And then there is probably the most comprehensive shot, for me at least, that I have here. It's the asteroid quick shot. I actually like this shot. It looks pretty cool, like having this planet view and then the camera goes close to you, or can actually like make it the opposite direction so that the camera starts in front of you and then reveals a planet around you, like a small planet. And it's cool, but I wouldn't say that this shot is really cinematic, simply because of course, the first thing is that the camera doesn't move constantly. So it looks like, okay, the camera goes first a bit back, then it goes up again, and then like this planet comes. It doesn't look like a constant movement. There's no really like a fluid movement inside. So that's why I wouldn't say that it's really, really like cinematic. But of course, it could be a nice shot to get some more attention of the viewer, because especially in cinematic videos, most YouTubers don't do that. So let's say if you're the one that does that shot maybe to start or end every single video that you do, then it's something that makes you unique and stand out from the rest. So that shot can be nice, but I wouldn't really call it cinematic. So let's get away from the quick shot modes and let's talk about the flight modes that I usually prefer to use to get cinematic shots, especially about myself. And that's mainly because I can control those non-quick shot modes better. Simply, I can like focusing on an object or something and like fly left or right, or depending what I want, just like I said before. And the shots that I most use there are the active track modes. And the first mode there is simply like the following mode. And following means that it's constantly following you. Like when you walk away, the drone will follow you. When you go to the left, the drone will follow you to the left, like flying behind you, of course. And what you can also do in this shot, what's pretty nice, you can actually adjust that the drone flies circles around you. So it's a bit like the circle quick mode shot. But the good thing here, or the bad thing, is that you can do that while you're walking. So before, with the quick shot mode, the circle, it's better to just stand in one place because the drone will not really recognize when you walk away. But when you do active track, the drone still tracks you while flying around you. So that's pretty cool here. And also, of course, you can do all the other stuff like pan and tilt the gimbal. You can fly by yourself, like closer and farther away. You can actually control by yourself to fly a circle and so on. If you want to shot or to make a shot of another person, for example, that's pretty interesting. Then there is the profile mode, and profile is pretty cool because it keeps all the time the same distance and the same angle to your subject. So that's pretty nice when you want to move around and the camera should like follow you all the time in the same place. It makes it a bit easier. And then there's also the spotlight mode. And spotlight is awesome because it's not like following you, it's just keeping you in the frame, in the middle. So like the drone stays in place all the time, even if you move away, it will not fly behind you or with you in any direction, but it will like follow you with a camera. And that's pretty nice because especially, let's say you want to do some kind of storytelling where, let's say, you're walking a path, so first camera a shot is maybe behind you, then the next camera shot films you like you're walking like that, like you're walking here and the camera is following you. That's pretty cool, and so you can actually create good sequences of following shots with that. It's pretty interesting. So these are the three shots for active track, all pretty good to create some cinematic stuff and to tell stories. But there's also another mode that I actually use a bit more, and this is the tripod mode. Tripod mode sounds like the drone would stay in one place, but it doesn't. It actually means that it slows the complete drone down. And it's not like just slows it a little bit down, it slows it crazily down. And that's good because Like you, when you watch my videos, you see that I really like to fly close to objects. And when doing that, it's much better to fly very slow with your drone. Because of course, at first it's safer, it's less likely that you crash your drone. But second, also it looks nicer. Because when I would fly pretty fast with my drone close to a tree or something, then it's just too fast and it doesn't look beautiful anymore. And of course, you can do that when you move your joystick only a pretty slightly bit, but it's easier when you use tripod mode. So I really love tripod mode. It's pretty cool, gives me more options and more flexibility. I was actually shooting also for a luxury spa here in Thailand with tripod mode, getting some shots, like someone walking in my direction, the drone was moving backwards, and then the moving and then the drone was like moving to the left and down while the massage girl was kneeling down to present some drinks. And yeah, like without the tripod mode it would never have been possible. So great mode here, thanks DJI for that. And yeah, there's also another mode, I don't use it much, it's the cinematic mode. And we talked before about that when you change the direction while flying your drone, for example, that you want to have a smooth transition between the directions and you don't want to switch like poof. And yeah, like the cinematic mode is actually good for that, because it's not really just slowing down your drone, but basically slowing down all those changes in speed. Like when you stop your drone and change direction, it all looks a bit smoother. So if you want to make more bigger moves, but you want to make those changes or stop the drone or something, and it should look smooth and not like braking fast or something, then the cinematic mode is perfect for that. And yeah, it's basically everything. In other shots, I would use the tripod mode. Another nice flight mode is the tap to fly, and you can actually use that when you want to film yourself without being the center object in the frame. And also if you don't want to use your controller, because you just tap on your screen and the drone is automatically flying in that direction that you tap before. You can also fly curves and so on, it's pretty nice. And you're just one of the objects inside the shot then, but you're not the main focus object anymore. So that's, for example, pretty cinematic. Also when you, let's say you're on a cliff and the drone was like flying above you, so that first you're in the shot, maybe in the middle, and then the drone actually flies above you and you can only see the ocean. So pretty cinematic there. I used it also for some advertising shots of myself showing me like how I do videos of the ocean. Like I was on Koh Lanta here in Thailand, pretty nice island, and I was standing on some cliffs there and I used tap to flight while I was there like filming with my camera and so on, so that the drone moved like 5 meters away from me or so and filmed me like filming there, and then went actually farther and only was filming the ocean. So very nice shots for that. Of course, active track is also nice for those shots, because I'm still the focus object there, I want to film myself. So you can actually mix it and that's pretty cool. So yeah, tap to flight is nice for that, and you should consider that when you don't want to be your main focus object and you don't want to be all the time in the shot. So at the end I also have some tips here on how to actually get cinematic shots out of that, because when you do a quick shot or shooting something in a flight mode, it doesn't necessarily mean that it looks cinematic. So the difference to a cinematic shot is that you cut out the best sequence of that clip. You don't want to show like 10 to 30 seconds, like the complete shot that you did. No, you only want to show the most important part. So for example, if I would use the boomerang mode, then I would have two options. At first, the first option would be if I want to show my face before and then reveal the background before me, then I would only show that part of the image, like first my face and then the drone flying around me, maybe until a 45 degree angle on the left side of me and on the back. And yeah, I mean, that's already enough to show my face and reveal the scenery where I stand. So I don't need to show more, it would just be boring and it wouldn't show anything new. So just show the stuff that it's actually interesting, don't show anything twice or so on. And the other option I would have with the boomerang is to just use the part of the shot that acts behind me or that happens behind me, because there it's actually like this cinematic part where I'm in front of this big scenery, like in front of the ocean on a cliff or something. So that's pretty cool to do there. And of course it also counts for other shots. So if you want to fly a circle around yourself, then you only want to show the part of the shot that is actually interesting. So, I mean, if you, let's say, you want to reveal a building behind you, then you will only show the angles or part of the clip that shows this building or that reveals this building, right? So that's also important to consider there. And yeah, the next thing, of course, it's also when cutting those shots is to smooth it out. So like we discussed before, you don't want the camera like changing directions too fast or something. You want to have a smooth, constant movement, and then it also looks cinematic. And this is all stuff that you do in post-production. So you get your quick shots, or you make the shot in the flight mode you want to have, and then in post-production later you look what's nice about the footage, what do I need for the shot and what not, and also you adjust it to the music. So you have the beats in the music and you cut to the beats. Of course you can skip a beat one time, like having one sequence two beats long or something like that, if it adds something to your video. But I wouldn't do too long, because one big mistake that a lot of beginners do, both with drones and normal cameras, is that they cut their clips too long and not to the music. So for example, it happens a lot with drone shots, because like you can do so long movements with a drone that actually the shots are just too long. Like sometimes it's like 30 seconds just flying in one direction. It's so boring, everyone will click away the video because no one likes to see that anymore. Then you need some variety in shots in your videos. You need to tell a story with your shots, and then it becomes interesting. And fortunately, drones, especially the Mavic Air, because of its size, are great filmmaking tools. Like especially the Mavic Air, you can bring it everywhere with you, and you have it out and in the air so quick that there is no excuse anymore to don't get a shot that you want to get. So it's amazing, and I would say that without the Mavic Air, or at least any other drone, no filmmaker should be there anymore, because like, yeah, it makes everything so much easier, not just storytelling, but also getting smooth shots. So much for that video. I really hope you liked it and you will get a bit nicer, more cinematic footage now with using quick shots and flight modes. So yeah, if you liked this video and I was able to help you, then I would be happy if you click the subscribe button. Now you will get more videos in the future about the Mavic Air and also about other drones and camera equipment and so on. And you will see some more of my travels. I'm actually in Phuket on Thailand right now. We'll visit some of the smaller neighbor islands in the next few weeks. So check my channel out to see those videos, and see you there.